And a good Monday to each and every one of you. Thank you so much for checking out the Tropical Update with me. My name is Jewel, and this is the Weather Channel of J7409. Rena, forget Rena. She probably won't even show up again later today on this map. She's just a remnant low. That's all she is. Her winds are 30 miles per hour. Pressure 1010 millibars, located 27.1 north, 55.4 west. Rena is moving north, due north at 13 miles per hour. Philippe, this is another can of worms. Everybody in the island area, you got to look out for. The winds haven't died down, still 50 miles per hour. They're a little bit more than that, and it does have wind gusts in the 60s. Now, the pressure is 998 millibars. It's located 17.1 north, 60.0 west, and it is moving northwest, still at 7 miles per hour. Here we go with the National Hurricane Center tracking map. Two little yellow dots, Antigua and Barbuda. You are still under a tropical storm watch. Now, I think maybe, just maybe, some other areas may be included in this. So make sure you keep up with your local weather and your local authorities if any changes happen. Like I told you late yesterday evening, I have a doctor's appointment. I'm doing this fast as I can. I have to be gone for a while today, but as soon as I can get back and get settled, I'll check everything out and make a new video for you. But this is what it's looking like as of right now. Tropical storm all the way up till Friday. Friday it should be out of everybody's hair. It will turn into a hurricane, and Bermuda, it'll be well east of you, but you still might get some wind out of this, maybe in the 30s, the 40s, something like that. I just checked out some different things a while ago before I got on here, and looks like you might still get some wind. And some of you guys down here in these areas, you will get some wind. Now, it's looking like Philippe should get past you maybe tonight or tomorrow sometime. That's what it's looking like to me right now. Now, here's the key messages for everybody in the island areas. Tropical storm conditions are possible across portions of the northern Leeward Islands through tonight, while Philippe passes near or just northeast of the area. Tropical storm watch is in effect for Antigua and Barbuda. Interests elsewhere in the northern Leeward Islands should continue to monitor this system. Now, there should be some heavy rainfall for some of you from Philippe, and it could produce isolated to scattered flash flooding, particularly across Barbuda and Antigua through Tuesday. And you can see what the winds are looking like in 12 hours, 50, 24 hours, 50 mile per hour. Now, the winds would be higher, but I don't think you'll get those higher winds, and you may not get 50 unless it actually does hit you. But you are going to have some pretty strong winds go across in certain areas. I'd say in the upper 30s to 45, maybe in the upper 40s mile per hour winds, that's going to happen, and you are going to get some rain. Once it gets past you, it's going to start to intensify. And here we go, up to 85 miles per hour. Okay, let's check out the rain. Barbuda and Antigua, 4 to 6 inches. That's what you can expect. The rest of the Leeward Islands looking like 2 to 4 inches. And the tropical storm conditions, once again, are possible in the watch areas beginning later today. Now, you're going to have swells from the ocean by Philippe. And, of course, that's going to affect the Atlantic coast of the northern Leeward Islands, the Virgin Islands, and Puerto Rico through midweek coming up. Now, these swells are likely to cause life-threatening surf and rip current conditions. Once again, be careful if you are in the water. Don't be in the water unless it's safe, because rip currents, they're a killer. They'll get you if you're not if you don't know what you're doing. So, and these swells, that's going to maybe cause some erosion around your areas too. So be aware of this and stay safe. Main thing I'm going to focus on with this video will be Philippe, which is right here. That's what's left of Rena. That's pitiful. She's just a remnant low. She's probably not even going to show up in the National Hurricane Center anymore since I just showed you this update from them right here. Of course, we do have low coming down this area, but everything in the Gulf is looking okay. Later on, you may see something that looks like it wants to form, especially along the coastline of Texas moving down, but it shouldn't turn into anything. If it does, it's going to wait till it crosses over Mexico, and it could meet up with another low and become a very intensive hurricane. Over in this area, just another tropical wave. Jamaica, you're looking good. Puerto Rico, everybody, this is around 5 a.m. this morning. Here we go here. I'll blow this up in a second. Let's move up in time if we can now. Let's get up to around, say, around 9 p.m. this evening. Now you can see it is beginning to affect some of the areas just a little bit. Let's see if we can blow this up a little bit for you. I want you able to get a real good look at this. You can see right down here. I think St. John is going to get more wind than what people are thinking right now. But this is at 9 p.m. this evening. You can see down in the southern section, St. George, Trinidad, Tobago, Kingstown, Bridgetown, all you guys, you're okay. This is once again around 9 p.m. this evening. Everything's still looking good. Over in the Dominican Republic and Puerto Rico, still looking good, still looking good. Now, by 2 a.m. tomorrow morning, you can see some of this wind now is beginning to pick up. Now, here's the highest intense wind. I don't think you're going to get it. I think it will stay north-northeast of you, but St. John's, let's check out these winds. 45 mile per hour wind gusts. Now that's your wind gusts, not your sustained winds. And you can see right down around in this area here, looking like 36 miles per hour. And some of the circulation of this thing now is beginning to come over in maybe Puerto Rico, Roadtown, and Marigot, you're going to get some winds too. Don't look too bad right now as we move up in time. For tomorrow morning around 11 a.m., let's bring this up some right in little island right here, right in the wind field. It's still not quite that bad, but looking like the winds around here, 42 miles per hour, right on in this area here. Everybody else in these areas, you should be in the upper 20s or maybe the 30s around Marigot, Bassarat. Let's see what this is here. 31. Looking like over this area, Puerto Rico, you're still doing great. And we'll come down some, as you can see. Most of these winds right here, all the way down to the catastrophes, these winds are only going to be maybe gusting in the 20s. We'll see what this looks like here. Yeah, 26 miles per hour. So this is what it's looking like. I think St. John area right in here, I think you guys, and maybe right in here, but I'm really thinking St. John, you may get more wind out of this than anyone else. We'll bring down the size some right now, and you can see, once again, this is tomorrow morning around 11 a.m., and by tomorrow around 8 p.m., let's see what happens. And as you can see, by tomorrow evening, around 8, 9 p.m. tomorrow evening, it is going to be pushing all away from guys. This is the Euro model. This is what the Euro is showing. This is what I'm showing. Still a little breezy down around St. John area. Let's see what we got here. 29 mile per hour wind gusts. That's just the wind gusts. Your sustained winds are much less, okay? And everybody else in the islands, and you're doing just fine, dandy. We do have a tropical wave that's going to be bringing some wind with it down to Trinidad and Tobago down in this area right here, but it's not bad at all. Nothing you're not used to. 25 mile per hour gust. It will be windy. Your regular winds will probably be anywhere from 10 to 15 miles per hour, something like that. But you are going to have some gusty winds down in this area tomorrow evening from a tropical wave coming through. And you can see now still this area up here around St. John and Morigot, you're still getting some of these winds, but it's going to get out of your hair. Now, this is around Tuesday at 9. Let's hop on up, say around 12 hours to Wednesday around 9 a.m. And boom, it is gone. It's not bothering you anymore, as you can see. We might have a little bit of wind over here, but it's nothing. It's maybe 5 or 10 miles per hour in the Turks and the Caicos in this area here. Also over in the Bahamas, not at all out of the ordinary. Jamaica, you're doing fine, dandy. Dominican Republic, and also Puerto Rico. Everybody's doing it. Now, I am going to bring it down to size some right quick. Like yesterday, I showed you. Now, this has got to warm up. Hold on. Yesterday, I said something coming off the coast of Africa. I didn't think it was going to make up. Well, I still don't think it is going to, but it's too far ahead. We cannot forecast this. This is like the 11th of October. So, the reason I'm saying it might make up, it doesn't look like a whole lot of anything, but you see right in here, it's trying to become a low, and it is a low with a barometric pressure of 29.87. Now, it's a little different than this low here. This is an elongated low. This is a, and there's only one isobar. This is still a low pressure system. But we're going to have to check, and we're going to have to watch this one, folks, because it could form, it could become something. We're going to have to wait and see. It's too far out. I just want to stick that in the back of your head so you don't forget about it. Let's hope if there's a lot of wind shear or there's some dry air mixing in with it and all kind of other things that it does not form. But I'm just saying, I didn't think it would even become a low with a barometric pressure yesterday, and now it's showing up today. And that's what it's looking like. Hey, everybody, stay safe. All of my island friends, stay safe. All of my friends in the U.S., stay safe. We got lots of catastrophic weather going on with all the flooding in New York and this and that and all the other. 2023 has been a year to remember with weather tragedies of all kinds. And I have a feeling this winter, a lot of people's going to get a whole lot of snow. Yep. So, with that all said and done, hey, have a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day. Share this information with your friends, your family, and on your social media to help me keep people aware and safe of what might be coming their way. Thank you so much for every single thing you do for me. I love you all very, very much, and I hope each of you have much peace, love, and kindness in your life today. Thank you for watching.